I recently made the decision to get clean from an addiction to prescription drugs. A problem I kept hidden from my wife, my family, my friends, everyone. It has haunted me for almost 3 years. It really started to spiral out of control this past year and a half, and I almost lost everything. Finally, I decided I couldn't keep hurting my wife or myself this way, and I was going to get my life back.
Okay, so let's start with August 15th when you posted about it on Instagram and just kind of put it out there to the world. Kind of run me through what was going on there.
I had already made the decision to get clean and turn my life around.
This picture was taken this year. It symbolizes my decision to get clean from an addiction to prescription drugs. This was me getting on the wagon and staying on the wagon. This picture was my way of making my beautiful wife laugh during one of the most difficult times in our life.
About 4 years ago, I dislocated my kneecap in a match, and there was no damage or structural damage, but it was painful, and the doctor prescribed me stuff just to get through the pain while I did rehab, and he just kept prescribing it to me and prescribing. And it wasn't as bad of a problem then. I just kind of was dealing with the pain, and then I would kind of go every day taking it, but I was fine. But then right before I did a tour of Japan, I broke a rib. And I had to go on the tour. Like, it was our income. There was no other way around it. And plus, I was teaming up with another guy, and I was like, that's his income. So we were going to do a tag tournament. I was like, I can't leave him high and dry. So I went to the doctor, and then he prescribed me something stronger. And then that got me through the tour. And then after that, I had a lot of downtime. So you go from being in pain, and this gets you through the work, and then it gets you through the day when you're bored. And then you're just taking it morning, afternoon, night, morning, afternoon, right. Night. In your head, you know you have an issue, you know you have a problem. But to me, it was like, I don't want anyone to think of me that way.
Right. People, they have this idea of what an addict looks like.
Right.
An addict looks like the scary person that's in a movie. And I think, that surprised people a lot. It surprised my own family. When my family saw him after he had told me that he had this problem, they looked at him, they're like, you don't look like anything's wrong.
I don't like keeping secrets, but I felt that was my only option, and I hated it. I knew I had to change. I had to be held accountable.
It was a secret to everybody. My own wife didn't know, my family didn't know. So I thought if I could show people that this could affect me, someone that no one would expect, it just felt like, I don't know, it just felt like the right thing to do. It felt like, all right, you know what? Reach out to these people and maybe they can look at you and have a voice. It's something that's not really talked about that much and no one ever thinks it will affect them. And I know that sounds cliche, but like when I decided to tell her, it's like, then everything spirals in a good way, but everything's like, oh wow, this does happen to everybody in any situation, in any job.
Well, just to put you in like such a vulnerable spot, you have to be so open with everybody about it, right?
Yeah, and I think that's, to me, it was about accountability too. Maria was holding me accountable. My family was holding me accountable. And then I was like, you know what? I have this career where millions of people are looking at me all the time. If they can hold me accountable and I can do some good, then this is the right way to go. I can defeat this and beat this.
You didn't know, but now, you know, in hindsight, it's 2020. What are some of the signs that maybe you saw?
Oh, you kick yourself.
Yeah.
You definitely kick yourself. You're like, why did I know? When he would wake up in the morning, he was like exhausted.
Right.
I was irritable. I was angry. I was like, what is wrong with me? And subconsciously I knew, but then I just convince myself it was just, well, it's just a bad day and then tomorrow will be better, or I'm sore from wrestling, or it's this, or it's raining out, or I just justify whatever it was that day. I think to me irritability was the biggest thing.
Yeah, that, and then you didn't want to do anything.
No.
He turned into such a hermit, and I thought it was me, and it's what I've heard from so many people. They're like, well, maybe it is just me, and I drive myself nuts of like knowing there's something wrong. But what is that something? I couldn't find it.
Addiction has taught me a few things. One of those being to never underestimate the power and impact of the people around you. to never undervalue your influence on them.
What's the reception been like for you guys since you've kind of made it public to everybody in the WWE universe and everybody beyond even?
I've had so many people tweet me and they were like, your post or Maria's post started a conversation with my husband or my wife.
Yeah.
And then I'm just like, oh, wow. The fact that they were talking wrestling or talking about me or Maria or a post we put up, and then all of a sudden they're like, all right, I have this problem too. Now we need to deal with it. Just because I reached out, to me, that's been the best part. It's overwhelming. It really has been.
Marriage, it's a sacred bond between two hearts. And I lost sight of a lot of things during my addiction. Luckily, my wife, she never took her eyes off us.
I mean, you guys have been in this business for how long?
Well, I've been doing it for 16 years now.
Mm-hmm. I've been in it for 13, and we've been working together for 6 years. For the first 3 years, he wasn't addicted to anything. And then for the last 3 years, he was. Mm-hmm. And I didn't know. So many people might think, oh, I would leave him. You know, I wouldn't stand by that. I wouldn't allow that to happen. You know, how dare they lie to me? But at the same time, it's your husband.
Yeah.
You know, you make vows. I was raised that way. There's a great quote that I always go to, and that's, you know, two old people are asked, you know, how'd you make it work all these years? And the wife says, well, I was raised in a time that when something was broken, you fixed it.
I saw you post that, and mm-hmm. I loved it.
That's the one quote that I definitely have been leaning on the most.
I've finally seen the light at the end of the tunnel. Something that seemed so out of reach just a year ago. I am not alone, and I know that I never was. Now, it's up to me to help others see that light too.
Is there something that you want to say to all of your fans and supporters and people that might be in your position or know somebody that's in that position, just as like a final kind of thought to them?
I think for me, it's just, it's okay to talk to someone about it. I think if you think you have a problem, I would say chances are you probably do. Start the conversation, you know? And like I told people on Twitter, just keep tweeting me. I want people, because I think if people just tweet it out, then they're like, okay, now we can do something.
Yeah.
Or, you know, or even if they see someone that they look up to or admire, they're just like, okay, he went through it, I can too. And I just think like, if I can do it, you know, with a stressful job, hiding it from my family, all these eyes on me, I think so many people can do it. And I just think, I just want people to know that.
Almost every parent I've ever talked to says, you're never ready for children, but it's perfect timing when they come.
We're having a baby!
Surprise!
Surprise!
My 2017, in a nutshell, I went from starting the year knowing that I had this addiction and this problem and I was destroying my life, and to going to achieving my dream job that I worked 16 years for and finally coming clean. Fast forward till now, from up to down to up to down, and then it's definitely been a whirlwind.
They always say that God never puts anything in your path that you can't handle. And I truly believe that. I think that this universe only gives you challenges that you can fight through, and that's what we'll continue doing.
You know, ever since we announced that we're having a baby, a lot of the guys in the locker room have come up to me and told me it's the most wonderful experience that they've ever had in their entire life. I don't know what to expect, but I know that I'm excited. I'm real excited.